So let's say you spend some hours in ZBrush and you created the absolute best sculpt you ever done. And now you want to create a time lapse of it to share it with the world in order to prove that it is indeed you who has done it and not some scary AI, or to create a YouTube empire with dozens of views and single digit likes. Great, I'm going to show you how to do that. All right, now we're in ZBrush. Whenever you create any sculpt, ZBrush will create an undo history stack for all of your subtools. Every brush stroke you make will be recorded there. This information is what we will be using to create our time lapse. So it's very important to make sure that you save your work with the undo history enabled. To do this, you must save from the file menu and make sure undo history button is ticked on. If you have this off, or if you save the tool instead of the whole project and then open it later, your history will be gone and you won't be able to create a time lapse. Let's open a file that has the undo history saved. The first thing we do is change the document size to match the video resolution we want to output. In my case, it's 1920 by 1080 or Full HD. Notice how the values are linked by default. Unticking the Pro button solves this problem. Click on Resize and confirm that you indeed want to resize your document. Your sculpt has now been dropped to canvas. Since the canvas was resized, it is looking rather pixelated. Press Ctrl+N to clear the canvas. Then, left mouse button drag your sculpt onto the canvas again. Hit T to go into the edit mode. Let's dock the movie menu so we can see the options better. You can hover over any button or menu item in ZBrush while pressing Ctrl to see Pixelogic's description of what it does. First, we have the dock and window buttons. If we choose dock, the only thing recorded will be the document, the ZBrush's working area where all your sculpting is taking place. Window will leave the menus and the interface in the movie. Which one you choose is entirely up to you. Window will render the movie at the resolution of your monitor. If you choose dock, the document resolution settings we changed earlier will be used by ZBrush as the output size. Large, medium and small buttons will determine the scale percentage of your chosen resolution. Large will be 1:1, medium will be half the size of that, and small will be 1/4. By default it is set to medium. Let's change it to large. Now let's dive into the modifiers sub-palette. Here there will be a few things we can change that will affect how our video recording looks like. H-frames is the slider that sets the quality of interpolation between each recorded history point. It is at 4 by default, and I tend to leave it there, but if you have very long undo history, setting it to something like 2 can help reduce the movie recording time at the cost of some interpolation quality. For now, let's leave it at default. H position determines how much the mesh can move in the camera's view at the time of recording the movie. I prefer to set it all the way down to 0, so the mesh will always stay in the center where I positioned it. H size determines how much camera zooms in and out during the recording of the movie. Higher values will try to match the zoom to be the same as what was used while sculpting. Again, I set it to 0 because I don't like the zooming in and out motion in my time lapses. H orientation controls the orientation of the model in relationship to the camera. Just like with the two options above, higher values will try to match the orientation of the sculpting phase. I usually set it to around 20. H camera path smooth does what it says on the tin. The higher the value, the smoother the motion of the camera will be. Personally, I'm not a huge fan of the smoothed out camera look, and with the above settings I used, there is not that much camera motion anyway, so I will set it down to 0. Next, let's disable the title image. This is basically ZBrush's logo that will be overlaid at the start and the end of our timelapse when we're exporting it as a movie. If we don't want it, then we can just set the fade in and fade out sliders to 0. Now we're done, let's just hit the F history and watch ZBrush do its thing recording the timelapse. Now that it's done, we can also click turntable a couple of times so we get a couple of 360 degree turns of our finished model at the end of our timelapse. You can now export the created movie by going to the movie menu, hitting export and choosing your output file location. ZBrush will do its thing, and that's it! You now have your sculpting time lapse ready.